So, imagine the rump, right? The worst evil, corrupt empire government ever. That's what we've got with Labour. He's now got his minions. They call them civil servants, and they're slaves, really. And now they're planning that if there is a hung up parliament, right, Gordon Brown will stay in power to save the planet. UK's economic crisis that he created. Yes, that is the reason he will have to stay in power. Because it's like an economic crisis that he made. He always governs. They're always making up a crisis and then saying, look, I fixed it, crisis. Now it's like, they've gone one better. It's like they're making a crisis and I have to stay in power to solve this crisis. You think it's a bloody wartime or something? The nuclear's falling out of the sky. Is he gonna, they're so creepy, they just take over like leeches. Like, because of this, I have to stay in power. You know, they make up their own bloody reason, whatever their little ideology is. I don't like people with freckles, and some freckled people might come in, and so I have to stay in power. This is just bloody sheer blatant power grabbing. Madness. He should leave. Okay. Went to the cinema. There's a little, it's like a little box room. Like, walked in the other day, right? Shutter Island, the boring one, K-Pax minus, and cinema's okay. I got there the evening after one time I went to the doctor's, and it was couple's time. I went home in the bloody dark. I had more fun going home in the dark. It was windy, dark, no lights in the bloody town park. Bike, black dogs flying across the bloody path. That was more bloody. That was more than me. Yeah, all that place film was boo boo boo. But in the old days, Star Wars. Danny Old Odeon, Dan Old Gazelle. Oh, the screen was up like that. It was an event. When you got home, like, it was like a roller coaster effect. Because like, you got home, look at your little telly in your little room, in your little living room, you're like, it's like a whoop effect. You're, you getting used to the whole scowl again, you know, when you come back home. Nowadays, it's like, oh, big telly, small telly, you know. There isn't no even effect like that. Because like out there, your eyesight was like, it was like, oh, the screen was like, and now it's like going into another TV room around the corner. Only, well, in this case, it's right across Play 10. 490, that's a bit steep, isn't it? So, and their bloody lens is a bit funny on that screen, because it's like around the edges. It wasn't, he didn't have the contrast, he wasn't holding the contrast, it was like grey around the edges. Yeah, dehydration hospitals. I do feel that people must get cleaned out. I think if I had people in my hospital, I'd have them cleaned out of that enema about 3 days in, if there's like, they're up for it. Because I think now that, this is why mum died. I think she had a lot of stuck up goo up there, right? Anyone with big stomach has, I think. And I think it's got through. And I think it affected her head. If she went a bit duh, and they got her in there for a fortnight. And then they took all her blood pipes out, her liquids, and the next day she was dead, right? And on the x-rays and all the stuff, it was mentioned blockage. So, and they didn't do enema. They just don't do enemas in hospital. This is what it seems to me. They're like, alright, and like the doctor's like, oh no, enema, no. It's like, no. It's like, what are you? Like, it might be a middle class thing, I don't know. Poo, chick, ow, unclean. I don't know, but I think I read up to that doctor, is it? That Kellogg's man, he's all in the bloody enemas and stuff. But I don't want to get bloody like psycho about it and obsessed and all the anal stuff. But actual for this modern day, the way we eat, you know, just chucking everything down the gullet, there is a problem at the other end, and it is affecting the blood and affecting the bodies. And it does need sorting out, and it's not being tackled in hospitals today, I don't think.